So I'm with Vinn from Russian River.
Hello.
Wanted to talk a little bit about food and beer pairings and flavors and beers and how those kind of work within, you know, dishes and flavors. I mean, I know we've done a lot of things together.
We've done
some fun things.
Yeah.
I always love how your beers have these really unique flavors and you really strive to get those flavors and, you know, how your mind works and how that translates to your palate.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about the flavors that you really enjoy in both food and beer.
I think from the beer standpoint, to begin with, and this is a common theme between most of our beers, is that they're pretty dry. And I really think dry beers make more food-friendly beer. And makes it easier for the chef to cook with and, of course, pair with as well. And, you know, of course, if you're dry, if you're sweet, any level of, you know, residual sugar is going to give you different flavors. But I also like the idea that not only do the pairings work better in general, but the fact that... Start over, you go. All right. So, the fact that you get... it's the flavor, you have the beer, it's on your palate, and then it's gone. You know, it's not a lingering, it's not a long lingering.
Like a port or something like
that. Yeah, yeah. And it allows you to move on to your next bite of food or your next course, if you will.
And it's just fun, you know, I think about like consecration and supplication with the fruit and those little hints of cinnamon and how those beers, I think, have so much complexity.
Yeah.
And, you know, to really look at beer as an ingredient, like I talk a lot about, you know, I really see that your beers really bring that full forward. You know
right.
What I mean?
Yeah.
There's
yeah.
no, I'm shy, I mean, so boom, here yeah. it is. And that's one thing I think is really admirable about, you know, a brewer who's aggressive and, like, you know, this is me in a bottle.
You know, and with those beers you mentioned, the consecration and the supplication, those are beers that on the surface you would think are sweet because they do have fruit in them, but because we put them in the barrel for so long, the breath dries them out, you then create some pretty unique flavors, you know, through that barrel aging process. And then you have the acidity from the bacteria there. You know, all those things contribute to the you know, the overall complexity of the beer. And in the end, you don't land with a sweet beer because the yeast has fermented it down. You know, I think in the big picture, again, it just goes back to having the dryness there, the crispness, and being able to allow the chef to do his or her thing.
Well, even from your hoppy beers, like the piney all the way through, you know, your Belgian beers. I mean, that's one of the reasons why I think I've always loved Belgian beers, because they are so dry. They're not just residual sweet,
yeah,
heavy,
yeah.
You know.
At least they're well-made
yeah.
Belgian or Belgian-style beer.
Very
but, you
true.
Know, with that in mind, too, the Belgian yeast, whether you're making a, you know, whether it's a Belgian brewer, whether it's a Belgian-inspired beer made in, you know, America, another part of the country, you know, that those yeasts have so much to offer because the brewer can ferment at a warmer temperature, which helps bring out different
esters,
phenols,
yeah.
phenolics. And so all those things, I think, allow the chef more of a, you know, palate to work with. And if you do it right, where you can blow off all the sort of bad esters and phenols, keep the good ones, which I think is something we do pretty good, you end up with a lot of really nice flavors, like you mentioned, cinnamon or just a different spice element, the clove and all that, and that's all being driven from the fermentation temperature. So
and it works with the fruit. I mean, it's really complementary. I mean, cherries and cinnamon work so well together.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, the temperature in which the brewer chooses to ferment at can directly affect, you know, what the chef ends up, you know, with the end product to work with, he or she's picking with a pairing for the beer.
Cheers, buddy. Thanks for your time.
Thanks. It's tough, buddy.
Live at Russian River.